الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. إن شاء الله تعالى tonight we're going to take a new chapter from the book of الإمام البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى, which is called شرح السنة, the explanation of the creed. قال المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى وعلم أنه لا يدخل أحد الجنة إلا برحمة الله. The author رحمه الله تعالى, he said, know that no one will enter الجنة except through the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. No one will enter الجنة except through the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وَلَا يُعَدِّبُ اللَّهُ أَحَدًا إِلَّا بِقَدْرِ ذُنُوبِهِ. And Allah will not punish anyone except according to their sins that they have committed. وَلَوْ عَدَّبَ أَهْلَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَرَّهُمْ وَفَاجِرَهُمْ عَدَّبَهُمْ غَيْرَ ظَالِمٍ لَهُمْ. He said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to punish the people, the inhabitants of the heavens and the earth, whether the good one and the righteous amongst them and the evil amongst them, Allah will punish them and he will not be oppressing them in the least. لا يجوز أن يقال لله تعالى إنه ظالم. It is not permissible to say that Allah is an oppressor. It's not permissible to say that about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنما يظلم من يأخذ ما ليس له. He said, the one who oppresses is the one who takes that which does not belong to him. والله له الخلق والأمر. And to Allah belongs the creation and the command. والخلق خلقه. And the creation is his. والدار داره. And the abode is his. The abode which is the abode of Jannah and the abode of the Hellfire. لا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. Allah is not to be questioned about what he does, but his creation are to be questioned. ولا يقال لما وكيف. And it's not permissible to say why. Like some people, they have this, والعياذ بالله, this habit of saying why. Why did Allah choose me? Why did Allah punish me? And so on and so forth. It's not permissible. Or to say, why did Allah do this? It's not permissible to say that. And also, kayfa, how? وَلَا يَدْخُلُ أَحَدٌ بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَبَيْنَ خَلْقِهِ. No one should enter between Allah and his creation. Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan, حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, he is going to explain to us this chapter. قَوْلُهُ وَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا يَدْخُلُ أَحَدٌ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا بِرَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. The statement of the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, that none will enter al-Jannah, paradise, except through the mercy of Allah. Sheikh Salih bin Fawzan al-Fawzan, he said, al-Jannah ghaliya wa rafi'a. He said, paradise is very precious and extremely lofty. Wala tudraku bil-amal. And it cannot be achieved through actions. It cannot be achieved through good actions by themselves. No matter how righteous you are, can you pay back Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his blessings? You cannot pay him back for the blessing of Tawheed, the blessing of Al-Iman, the blessing of the Sunnah, the oxygen that you breathe, the water that you drink. Allah gave you a righteous wife, good children, and a good house, wealth. You're not sick. So many blessings that it's impossible for you to count them. As Allah said in the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you were to count the blessings of Allah upon you, you will not be able to. So no matter what, how righteous you are, you will not be able to enter al-Jannah through your deeds. But you enter al-Jannah through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh, he said, مهما عمل الإنسان ولو عمل كل الطاعات فإن عمله لا يقابل النعم التي عليه. The Sheikh, he said that even if the servant was to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the way through, he can never pay back Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings that he bestowed upon him. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to put the blessings on the day of judgment on one pan of the scale and your deed on the other pan of the scale, the blessings of Allah will outweigh your deeds. Right or wrong? Will outweigh all your deeds. Even one blessing that you are a Muslim. Allahu Akbar. And that's why one of the Imams of the Salaf, his name is Bishr al-Hafi rahimahullah, one time he was coming to his home. And when he was going to enter the house, he put a step forward and then he began to reflect and ponder for a long time. So some people, they noticed, you know, the man, he froze, like he was thinking and reflecting. So they said, why did you have to freeze up like that? He said, I was thinking about Bishr the Christian, and Bishr the Jew, and Bishr the Hindu. And I was thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I am Bishr the Muslim. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. How many people, they have the same name as you, but they're not Muslims? So you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are Muslim. You should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are Muslim. And you can never pay him back for this ni'mah of Islam. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you to be Muslim among so many people. And I know some of you used to be Christians. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose you among all these Christians. Allahu Akbar. This is a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can never pay him back for this. Let alone the other favors and the other blessings that he has bestowed upon you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh, he said, فَلَوْ حُوسِبَ عَلَى النِّعَمِ لَمْ يَبْقَ عِنْدَهُ عَمَلٌ هَذِهِ نَاحِيَةٌ. He said, from what angle? The Shaykh, he said, from what angle? If the servant was to be put to accountability, if the servant was to be put to accountability in regards to the blessings that Allah bestowed upon him, he said, no good deed would be left out. No good deed will be left out. No good deed will be left out. This is from the first angle. النَّحْيَةَ الثَّانِيَةَ, the second angle, أَنَّ الْجَنَّةَ غَالِيَةَ, that paradise is very precious. وَلَيْسَ لَهَا قِيمَةٌ مُقَدَّرَةٌ مِنَ الْأَعْمَالِ. He said, Al-Jannah doesn't have any value in terms of the actions. You cannot compare Al-Jannah with your actions. There is no value for Al-Jannah except through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter how hard you try, you know, but you can never pay Allah back for the blessings that He bestowed upon you. And you can never win His paradise just like that through your deed. The Shaykh, he said, you cannot win it through your deeds or wealth or other than that. لَا يَعْلَمُ عِظَمَهَا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. No one knows the greatness of Al-Jannah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh, he said, لَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدْخِلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الْجَنَّةِ بِرَحْمَتِهِ. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter the believers to His paradise through His mercy. بسبب أعمالهم. بسبب أعمالهم. Because of their deeds. Because of their deeds. But it doesn't necessarily mean that the deeds are the ones that is through His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it doesn't necessarily mean that you say, well, I'm just gonna slack off and then I'm gonna rely on the mercy of Allah. La, it doesn't mean that. You work hard and you do the best you can to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to acquire as many good deeds as possible. And then you hope for the mercy of Allah after that. The Shaykh, he said, فَالْأَعْمَالُ إِنَّمَا هِيَ سَبَبٌ لِدُخُولِ الْجَنَّةِ. He said, actions, they are just a mean to enter al-Jannah. وَلَيْسَتْ هِيَ الْمُوجِبَ لِدُخُولِ الْجَنَّةِ But the actions, they are not the reason to enter al-Jannah. But they are a mean to enter al-Jannah. But they are not the main reason. The main reason is the mercy of Allah. وَلَا تَمَنَ لِلْجَنَّةِ He said, paradise has no price. It's priceless. Has no price. وَلِهَذَا قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ And for that reason, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدٌ مِنْكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ بِعَمَلِهِ He said, none of you shall enter al-Jannah through his good deed. None of you shall enter al-Jannah through his good deed. هَذَا مِنْ أَجْلِ أَلَّا يُعْجَبَ الْإِنسَانُ بِعَمَلِهِ So that the person does not get self-conceited with his actions. So does not get self-amazed. You see? Does not get self-amazed and self-conceited. لا لأجل أن يترك العمل. And also he should not leave doing good deed. وقوله تعالى ادخلوا الجنة بما كنتم تعملون. And the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, enter al-Jannah through the action, the good deed that you used to do. Surah An-Nahl. والباءُ هنا, the Shaykh he said, ادخلوا الجنة بما, through which. Through that which you used to do. So the Shaykh he said, through here, it doesn't mean is a recompense. It doesn't mean that. Or, he said, it's not a price. وَإِنَّا هِيَ بَابُ السَّبَبِيَّةِ But here, الْبَاءُ here is a reason or mean for that. So basically, you enter al-Jannah through your good deed as a mean. But the main reason for entering al-Jannah is through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدُكُمْ لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدٌ مِنْكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ بِعَمَلِهِ The Prophet ﷺ, he said, none of you shall enter al-Jannah through his good deed. قَالُوا وَلَا أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ He said, even you, O Messenger of Allah? He said, وَلَا أَنَا إِلَّا أَنْ يَتَغَمَّدِنِ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ He said, even myself, unless Allah covers me with his mercy. If this is the case with the Messenger of Allah, who are we? Allahu Akbar. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, even myself, I will not be able to enter al-Jannah through my good deed. He said, except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covers me with his mercy. فَلَا يُعْجَبُ الْإِنسَانُ بِعَمَلِهِ A person should not be conceited with his good deed. وَلَكِنْ لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا بِسَبَبِ الْعَمَلِ But al-Jannah, you will not be able to enter it except through a mean of good deed, for doing good deed. فَلَوْ لَمْ يَعْمَلْ مَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ If he does not do any good deed, he will not be able to enter al-Jannah. لِأَنَّهُ مَا أَتَى بِالسَّبَبِ Because this person, he did not fulfill the means. He did not fulfill the means. And the statement of the author, وَلَا يُعَدِّبُ اللَّهُ أَحَدًا إِلَّا بِقَدْرِ ذُنُوبِهِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will not punish anyone except according to the sins that they have committed. الْجَنَّةُ فَضْلٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَى وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ اللَّهِ The Shaykh, he said, Paradise is from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the person will enter al-Jannah through the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْأَعْمَالُ سَبَبٍ لِدُخُولِهَا And actions, they are mean to enter al-Jannah. وَأَهْلُ النَّارِ لَا يُعَدَّبُونَ إِلَّا بِدُنُوبِهِمْ He said, the people of the hellfire, they will not be punished except according to what they have done, for committed the sins. لَا يُعَدَّبُونَ بِدُنُوبِ غَيْرِهِمْ They will not be punished with the sins of others. وَهَذَا مِنْ بَابِ الْعَدْلِ And this is from justice. فَالْجَنَّةُ مِنْ بَابِ الْفَضْلِ وَالنَّارُ مِنْ بَابِ الْعَدْلِ So paradise is from the blessings of Allah. He bestowed this, subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon the believers. And he showers his mercy upon them and he entered them into his paradise. So his paradise is his grace and bounty and blessing. And the hellfire is his justice. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put someone in the hellfire through his justice, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not wrong this person. He did not oppress this person. وَقَوْلُهُ And the statement of the author, وَلَوْ عَدَّبَ أَهْلَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَرَّهُمْ وَفَاجِرَهُمْ عَدَّبَهُمْ غَيْرَ ظَالِمٍ لَهُمْ And the statement of the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, if Allah was to punish the inhabitants of the heavens and the earth, the righteous amongst them and the wicked amongst them, he will punish them and he will not be oppressing them. هَذَا كَمَا سَبَقْ أن الإنسان مهما عمل فإن عمله لا يقابل بعض نعم الله عليه. He said this as it preceded. He said because the servant, no matter how good his righteous deeds is, he will never be able to compare it with some of the favors and the blessings of Allah. Some, not all, some of them. فَلَوْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَدَّبَهُ كَانَ ذَلِكَ عَدْلًا If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to punish this servant, this righteous servant, this would be from his justice. Right? لِتَقْصِيرِهِ فِي شُكْرِ نِعَمِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ Due to his deficiency in thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right or wrong? Because we all are deficient when it comes to thanking Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala for his blessings. Yes. وهذا الكلام الذي ذكره هو نص حديث عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the statement of the author رحمه الله is taken from this hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لو أن الله عدب أهل سماواته وأهل أرضه لعدبهم وهو غير ظالم لهم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to punish the inhabitants of the heaven and the earth, He will punish them and He will not oppress them. He will punish them and He will not oppress them. وَلَوْ رَحِمَهُمْ لَكَانَتْ رَحْمَتُهُ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ مِنْ أَعْمَالِهِمْ And if He was to shower His mercy upon them, then His mercy will be better for them than their good deeds. Allahu Akbar. His mercy will be better for them than their good deeds. لأن الفاجر عدبه بفجوره because the wicked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he punished him because of his wickedness والبر عدبه لأن عمله لا يؤهل لدخول الجنة and if he was to punish a righteous person he will punish him because his deed will not qualify him to enter Jannah his deed will not qualify him to enter al-Jannah. لأنه لا يقابل نعم الله عليه because those deeds, they will not be able to be compared with the blessings and the mercy and the bounties that Allah showered upon him. وقوله لا يجوز أن يقال الله إنه ظالم. And the statement of the author, it is not permissible to say about Allah that he is an oppressor. والعياذ بالله. نزه نفسه عن الظلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has freed himself from oppression in the Quran. Allah said, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِضَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ in Surah Fussilat. And your Lord does not wrong the slaves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not wrong his slaves. لَا ظُلْمَ الْيَوْمِ And Allah also said in Surah Ghafir, Today means the Yawm al-Qiyamah, there is no oppression. لَا ظُلْمَ الْيَوْمِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ Allah is swift in reckoning. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Kahf, وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا Allah will not wrong anyone. Allah will not wrong anyone. And he also said in Surah Zukhruf, وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا هُمُ الظَّالِمِينَ And we did not wrong them, but they were the wrongdoers. But they were the wrongdoers. And also the hadith al-Qudsi, Ya ibadi, inni harramtu al-dhulma ala nafsi, وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. In the Hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servant, I have made oppression haram upon myself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made oppression haram upon himself. And I have made it haram amongst you. So do not oppress one another. That shows you the danger of oppression. And also Hadith, Prophet ﷺ said, اتقوا الظلم فإن الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة. Be aware of oppression, because oppression will be darknesses on the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that. And the poet says, لا تظلمن إذا ما كنت مقتدرا فالظلم ترجع عقباه إلى الندم تنام عينك والمظلوم منتبه يدعو عليك وعين الله لم تنمي. The Muslim poet, he said, لا تظلمن إذا ما كنت مقتدرا. Do not oppress if you have the ability to do so. فَإِنَّ الظُّلْمَ تَرْجِعُ عُقْبَاهُ إِلَى النَّدَمِ. Because the end result of oppression is regret. Is regret. تَنَامُ عَيْنُكْ. Your eyes sleep. While the person who you have oppressed, he's making dua against you. And the eyes of Allah do not sleep. This is the statement of a poet. Sheikh, he said, حَكَمٌ عَدْلٌ لَا يَلِقُ بِهِ الظُّلْمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most just, is not suitable. It does not befit His Majesty to have that trait and the characteristic of oppression. It does not suit and does not befit His Majesty. وَقَوْلُهُ إِنَّمَا يَظْلِمُ مَنْ يَأْخُذُ مَا لَيْسَ لَهُ والله له الخلق والأمر الظلم هو أخذ حق الناس. So the author رحمه الله تعالى, he said, oppression is when you take that which does not belong to you. That is called oppression. When you rob someone or somebody like you take his wealth and the like, this is haram. This is called ظلم. This is oppression. وهل الناس لهم حق على الله ليس لهم حق على الله ولا أحد يوجب على الله شيئا وإنما حق العباد على الله ألا يعذب من لا يشرك به شيئا هذا حق تفضل به سبحانه. He said, do the slave have a right upon their Lord? He said, they have a right upon him subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will not punish them provided that they worship him and they do not associate any partners with him. So as long as they don't commit shirk. And this right, he said, is a right of blessing. Is a blessing, actually. Is a blessing. Is out of his bounty and out of his blessing. The Sheikh, he said, وَالظُّلْمُ هُوَ وَضْعُ الشَّيْءِ فِي غَيْرِ مَوْضِعِهِ. He said, oppression is when you do something that is not right. When you do something that is not right. فَاللَّهُ لَا يَضَعُ الْعَذَابَ فِي مَنْ يَسْتَحِقُّ النَّعِيمِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not punish the one who deserves to be in paradise. Would he? He will not do that. وَلَا يَضَعُ النَّعِيمِ فِي مَنْ يَسْتَحِقُّ الْعَذَابِ. And then he would not put someone who's doomed for the hellfire in paradise. بَلْ يَضَعُ النَّعِيمَ فِي مَنْ يَسْتَحِقُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will put the one that deserves to be in paradise, he will put him in paradise. وَيَضَعُ الْعَدَى فِي مَنْ يَسْتَحِقُهُ. And Allah will punish the one who deserves the punishment. He said, هَذَا هُوَ الْعَدْلِ. This is justice. أَمَّا الْعَكْسُ فَهُوَ الظُّلْمُ. And the opposite of that is oppression. وَلَوْ عَدَّبَ أَهْلَ الْإِيمَانِ وَأَكْرَمَ أَهْلَ الْكُفْرِ يَكُونُ هَذَا هُوَ الظُّلْمُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the people of Iman and he honored the people of Kufr, then this will be what? Oppression. وَاللَّهُ مُنَزَّهٌ عَنْ ذَلِكَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is free from that. Allah is free from that. لا يمكن أن يعذب أهل الإيمان, because it is impossible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish the people of Iman. وأن يكرم أهل الكفر, that he will and he will honor the people of kufr. وأن يدخل الكفار الجنة وأن يدخل المؤمنين النار, هذا لا يليق بالله سبحانه وتعالى. So it is not, it does not suit his, it does not fit, befit his majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter the kuffar to paradise and the believers to the hellfire. وقوله والله له الخلق والأمر والخلق خلقه والدار داره. إيجاد الأشياء من عدم, فكل المخلوقات خلقها الله. To Allah belongs the creation, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created things out of nothing. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا أحد يخلق مع الله. None can create alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, Allah خالق كل شيء. Allah is the one that created everything. والأمر له سبحانه. والأمر هو التشريع والوحي المنزل. الأمر, His command, is His legislation. Is His legislation and His revelation. The revelation that was sent upon Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فالخالق هو الذي يأمر وينهى. So the creator is the one that commands and prohibits. وَيَشْرَعُ لِعِبَادِهِ مَا يُصْلِحُهُمْ. And he is the one that legislates for his servant that which suits them. وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَمَّا يَضُرُّهُمْ. And Allah, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He warns them from that which will harm them. وَلَيْسَ لِأَحَدٍ أَنْ يَأْمُرَ أَوْ يَنْهَى أَوْ يُوجِبُ عبادة أو ينهى عن شيء من غير دليل. And it is not permissible for anyone to command the people to tell them do this or don't do this, or to call them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any evidence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أم لهم شركاء شرعوا لهم من الدين ما لم يأذن به الله. Do they have partners that legislated for them that which Allah did not permit? It shows you the danger of al-bid'ah, innovation. Because the innovator, it's like he's legislating. Because when the innovator, he promotes his bid'ah and he calls the people to it, it's like he's legislating. Because where does bid'ah come from? Yes, exactly. نعم. فالأمر لله سبحانه وتعالى الأمر الكوني والقدري. So the command belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, universal and legislative. وَالْقَدَرِ, that has to do with his qadr, with his predestination. وَالْأَمْرُ الشَّرْعِ يَأْمُرُ وَيَنْهَى. The legislative command, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands and He forbids. وَفَرَّقَ بَيْنَ الْخَلْقِ وَالْأَمْرِ. And in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala differentiated between the command and the creation. فَدَلَّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْأَمْرِ غَيْرَ مَخْلُوقِ. So this signifies that al-amr, the command of Allah, is not created. Is not created. وَفِي هَذَا رَدٌّ عَلَىٰ الْجَهْمِيَّةِ الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ. And in this, this is a refutation against al-jahmiyyah. Al-Jahmiyyah are the followers of Al-Jahm ibn Safwan. Because Al-Jahmiyyah, they say Al-Qur'an makhluq. They say Al-Qur'an is created. This is a refutation against them. Because the speech of Allah cannot be created. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qur'an, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. And Allah spoke to Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. And He also said, يريدون أن يبدلوا كلام الله. They want to change the speech of Allah. Another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ استجارك فَأَجِرُوا حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. If one of the mushrikeen comes to you, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, for protection, give him shelter until he hears the speech of Allah. So he calls the Quran his speech. And the speech of Allah is from his attributes. And the attribute of Allah cannot be created, as His essence cannot be created, so are the attributes. The attribute cannot be created. This is the Aqeedah of Al-Sunnah Wal-Jama'ah. Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he was imprisoned and he was beaten rahimahullah, and he was very firm and he did not give in rahimahullah ta'ala. وفي هذا the Sheikh said وإن كلام الله مخلوق والله فرق بين الخلق والأمر. So because this individual Al-Jahmiyyah, they claim that the speech of Allah is created. الله فرق بين الخلق والأمر, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he differentiated between the creation and the command. الأمر هو من الكلام. الأمر is from His speech. The command is from His speech. Like for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya Musa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He spoke to Musa, He said, Oh Musa, and so on and so forth. So, Ya Nuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Nuh, and so on and so forth. So wherever there is a command, it's the speech of Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has the right to command or to prohibit. طيب. The Sheikh said, وَالتَّشْرِيعُ وَاللَّهُ فَرَّقَ بَيْنَ الْخَلْقِ وَالْأَمْرِ فَدَلَّ عَلَى أَنَّ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ غَيْرُ مَخْلُوقٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala differentiated between the creation and the command. And this signifies that the speech of Allah is not created. Inshallah, we're going to stop here. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all العلم النافع والعمل الصالح. الحمد لله رب العالمين. وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. Anyone has a question? Between the creation and His command. What He created, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and His command. Because His command, this is a refutation against Jahmiyyah. Because Al-Jahmiyyah, they say Al-Qur'an is created. You understand? So the Shaykh is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ayah, He differentiated between the creation and the command. And the command is part of His speech. So His speech cannot be created. Yes, the other creation, they are created. Humans, jinn, angels, the throne of Allah, the footstool, the paradise, and hellfire, the angels, the heavens, the earth, they are created. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not created, nor is His attributes. So the attribute of Allah, they are not created. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His essence is not created, so His attributes are not created. And the command is from His speech, from His legislative speech. Now, yes, for
that. When you said the hellfire is just, that means that paradise is mercy, right?
Paradise is His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hellfire is His justice. Now, pardon.
As it pertains to the hellfire, I believe I read somewhere in the tafsir, whether it was in Kabir or Saudi, that almost hellfire is kind of like a purifier in a sense, in that because
if for the believers.
For the believers.
Yes.
So it's not necessarily
yes.
Everlasting. Like you can
yes.
be removed from the hellfire.
Absolutely. Because from the Aqeedah of Al-Sunnah Wal-Jama'ah, we believe that the people that commit major sins, those, they are under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If He wish, He will punish them, and if He wish, He will forgive them. So their affair rests with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. So if they go to the hellfire, they will go there just to be purified from the major sin that they have committed. If the Prophet ﷺ said, if the person who commit major sin gets punished here in this world, then this will be an expiation for him and purification, and he will not be punished in the next world. Like, for example, at the time Prophet, he flogged certain people, right? Or he stoned certain people that committed zina and the like. So though that punishment will be a purifying purification for them in this world, so they will not be punished twice. You see? They will not be punished twice. Now, nah, for it.
Yeah, but
that was done by the Prophet. Sallallahu alayhi wa if he commits murder, that's haram. There's no doubt about that. So, if he makes tawbah, and he seeks forgiveness from the people that he killed, you know, someone from them, and they forgive him, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him. But if he does not, like the people don't forgive him, then he has to deal with that situation on the Day of Judgment. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may even, if this person is good and he was sincere in his tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may even compensate the person who was killed. He will compensate, will give him some good reward to let this man enter paradise. It depends on his sincerity. You know, remember the man who killed 900 people. Remember the hadith. Yeah, and then he completed the ignorant person. He killed them too. So he killed 100. What happened to him in the end? He went to paradise. Nah.
So the justice from this world, like
yes,
if you get punished and you go to prison for the rest of his life,
yeah,
that will not do any good for him.
No, if he is sincere, if he makes tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him. No doubt about that. Because Allah forgives everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. Now. Why, yeah.
Well, on that, we said that Allah will even resurrect the animals and the
yes,
any injustice that was caused between the animals themselves, he would
yes,
resurrect them as well.
Yes. There's a hadith about that. Yes. Now. Now. Anyone has a question? That's it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge, righteous action. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim.